What's the word, y'all? Welcome to something I am calling NBA Every Day. I don't want you to take it too literal because no, I guarantee you this won't be literally every day. But I do want to talk about all 30 NBA teams to some capacity. And this pseudo series that I just started 5 minutes ago gives me an opportunity to talk about all 30 teams in no particular order. For example, today we're talking about the Sacramento Kings. You know, if I cared about the algorithm, I would probably talk about a team that made significant moves this offseason. But no, the Sacramento Kings are the team that is on my mind right now. So that is the team I am talking about. And I went with NBA Every Day because, first of all, it rhymes. And a good rhyme for a title was always pretty good. And when I typed in NBA Every Day, the first thing that came up was the NBA YoungBoy song. Me and him share the same first name, so I don't feel too bad about ripping that off. And I couldn't find another YouTuber that was using the name NBA Every Day. If it does exist, I will completely change the name. But as of right now, welcome to NBA Every Day. Does that feel good to say? Leave a like, man. We're starting off with the Sacramento Kings. Same format as the other videos. It's literally just a ramble. I don't have any notes in front of me or anything like that. It's just I want to talk about the Sacramento Kings because the last time the Sacramento Kings made the playoffs was 15 years ago. 15 years ago. Which means that there's a percentage of y'all watching this video that have never seen the Sacramento Kings in the playoffs. The last time the Sacramento Kings made the playoffs, Ron Artest was Ron Artest, and he was on the roster. The last time the Sacramento Kings made the playoffs, I'm pretty sure Mike Bibby was the starting point guard. And now he's like a bodybuilder. A lot of things have changed since the last time the Sacramento Kings made the playoffs, and I'm only saying that because I feel for the Kings fans. There's not a lot of fan bases that I can honestly say I feel sorry for them. The Sacramento Kings is that fan base for the NBA. Because every Sacramento Kings fan I've come across, they are some of the most passionate fans out there. And they deserve good basketball and they deserve playoff basketball. And that 15-year drought, of course it could end this season. I'm not saying they're locked to miss the playoffs in 2022. But with the Western Conference being as deep as it is, and with the Sacramento Kings not making any significant changes from their last year's team, it seems like they might end up on a 16-year streak of missing the playoffs, and that is absolutely devastating. This offseason for the Sacramento Kings was puzzling. I'm not even talking about the draft anymore. I've said it in a video for a few days ago, me and Davion Mitchell are homies. I hope them nothing but success. But the things outside of the draft were confusing. And I'm not saying that it's necessarily their fault that the Russell Westbrook trade got overpowered, so now Buddy Hield is still on the roster. But I thought this was going to be an offseason where they went in, they looked at what they had, De'Aaron Fox, Tyrese Haliburton, and everything else is up for grabs. I do absolutely love the re-signing of Rashawn Holmes. I think he is on an absolute steal of a deal. I thought that was a W. It's everything else that is very confusing to me. Right? For the last two seasons, it feels like we have been saying that Buddy Hield wants out, Buddy Hield will be traded, and they were this close to making it happen. They would have, if the details of the trade with the Lakers were true, they were about to bring in at least two very quality NBA rotation players to their team for Buddy Hield, and that would have been a W. We would be talking about different things in this video if that trade doesn't fall through, but it did. And there are very few times in NBA history where a trade is on the table, everybody thinks it's done, and it isn't. I know it happened in back-to-back years. It happened with the Kings two times. Oh, my God. With Bogdanovich, everything, we thought that he was going to trade for Dante DiVincenzo. That fell through like that. We thought Buddy Hield was going to trade it for, oh, my God, it's the Kings again. Oh, my God, the Kings. What is happening? It fell through, so we don't know what's really happening with Buddy Hield right now. There are rumors earlier today that, like, they are very, very interested in Pascal Siakam, which would be amazing. Pascal Siakam could definitely help your organization, can help you potentially make a playoff run. But what are we giving up? I say we because I'm talking as if I'm a fan. What are we giving up to get Pascal Siakam? What is Pascal Siakam's value to not just you as the Kings, but also the Toronto Raptors, considering he was an all-NBA player just a few seasons ago? I do believe if the Raptors are going to trade Pascal, they're not going to trade him at what his price is after last season. I think they trade him with the idea that you're getting a player that still has all NBA potential. And what are you giving up from the Sacramento Kings to get that type of trade to happen? Marvin Bagley? Buddy Hield? And what? Like, all the picks? I don't really know. Speaking of Bagley, this was an offseason where I was almost positive that he was going to be traded. Everything that has happened with him between his dad and De'Aaron Fox throwing shots at each other, with him deleting King stuff out of his bio and liking tweets talking about how he wants a new scenery. I just felt like Marvin Bagley being out of Sacramento was going to happen this offseason. And though the offseason's not completely over, I haven't heard a single rumor about it actually happen. So we have a player that we almost traded, a player that doesn't want to be there, all on my roster when I'm trying to make the playoffs for the fans. And then you also have Harrison Barnes, who you don't necessarily want to trade because he is one of the glue guys. He's one of the few super impactful players in your roster. You don't want to trade him to get younger because that's just telling your fans that you're going 2 more years to the rebuild. They are in this purgatory and I need them to get out. And I wish I had a solution for them, but I don't necessarily have it. I hated the moment that Dave Yeager was no longer their coach and they went to get Luke Walton. I won't lie to you and act like I watched all of 72 of their games this season and last season, but the games that I did watch of them, I can just say that Luke Walton did not seem fit for the job. I always go back to the fact that when Dave Yeager was coaching that team, I'm pretty sure they were like the 10th seed. This is before the play-in. I'm pretty sure they were like the 10th seed. They had some of the fastest paces in the league, and De'Aaron Fox was running. The man's name is Swiper. Luke Walton came into the organization and was like, we're going to take a team that was top three and pace, and we're going to turn them to a top five in pace team. Yep, De'Aaron Fox, get ready to learn how to shoot a jump shot. Don't use the advantage you already have. And yes, De'Aaron Fox has increased his jump shot, got better at his jump shot, and become a better player. But we're not necessarily capitalizing on what De'Aaron Fox's bread and butter is. The saving grace for all of this is the fact that Tyrese Haliburton fell to them in the draft last season. I don't know how it happened, but it is an absolute blessing. Because last year he was incredible. And you would hope that he builds on that, right? You would hope that you'll build on that. And that's why it also made sense that Buddy Hield was potentially going to be traded, because that just opens up more opportunity for De'Aaron Fox and for Tyrese to play together. But now it seems like Buddy's going to be suiting up this year. Seems like Marvin Bagley's going to be suiting up this year. HB is going to be suiting up this year. And where is the rest of it? Where's the rest of this roster that should be a playoff team or wants to be a playoff team? Hey, these people at Hoopsite, they got so much ad around here. Get some money, Hoopsite, get some money. But we want to look at some rumors revolving around the Sacramento Kings, man. They picked up some options. This is the one that's very interesting. I guess the two that are very interesting to me. According to league sources, the Kings are in the market to make something happen now. They're chasing big names and they will be aggressive in their search. Since taking over the Kings in September of last season, this always has been a plan for McNair. McNair? He set out almost the entire free agency window last year with the thought of retaining flexibility moving forward. Multiple sources tell the Sacramento Bee the Kings have shown interest in both Ben Simmons and Pascal Siakam, the two most prominent names linked to Sacramento Six to trade and free agency frenzy. Another rumor, Kings Pelicans discuss Buddy Hield, Josh Hart trade. I believe that would be such a W of a trade. I believe Josh Hart brings something to the team that they don't really have, and that's like super gritty, super gritty guy that defends and plays his role significantly well. Only problem is he's also a smaller, small forward type dude, but he plays big because he rebounds. So I would like this, considering it seems like you have to trade Buddy Hield now. To get back Josh Hart would be a W. Now, my next question, we were talking about the potential trades that they could pull off. If you're going for Pascal and you're going for Ben Simmons, one of the two, what package are you putting together? I think I said that earlier. One league source recently told the Sacramento Bee the Kings would have to send a minimum of 3 first-round picks to the 76ers in a trade constructed around Hield and Bagley. Another source said the 76ers wouldn't be interested unless Fox or Haliburton were included in the trade, but Hield's elite shooting and Bagley's unrealized potential could be appealing if a better deal does materialize. Which is interesting, because as of right now, the 76ers don't really have a ton of leverage when it comes to Ben Simmons. He's coming off a terrible playoff run for his personal self. And everything we've seen, he's not answering phones from anybody. It doesn't look like the Godfather offer that they're looking for Ben Simmons is out there. But even 3 first-round picks, Bagley and Hield, seems like not what the 76ers will want, mostly because the 76ers are a team that's trying to win a championship. Yes, Buddy Hield definitely can help you win a championship, considering, again, his elite three-point shooting, but it'll be hard to convince your fans we're trading a person that was second in defensive player of the year and a multiple-time all-star for a couple role players and players that are in high school right now. And then when it comes to Pascal Siakam, if this is a similar offer, you're probably not giving 3 first-round picks for Pascal. But if this is a similar offer, it really depends on what the Raptors are valuing him and what they want back in return. Because the Raptors are saying that they don't want to buy out Goran Dragic, which means to me that they kind of want to try to be competitive this season, at least a little bit. So I don't really know. But if this report is true, that they are that they might do this, or they're willing to throw in 3 first-round picks, Buddy Hield and Marvin Bagley for Ben Simmons, I like the aggression, because I do believe that Ben Simmons is a player that can put you over the hump as far as making the playoffs. I know it's the Wild Wild West and things ain't guaranteed, but Ben Simmons' elite-level defense is something that they can definitely use. But I would wonder what type of ceiling that puts on your team. You can argue that with Buddy Hield, De'Aaron Fox being so young, Reese being so young, and I think Ben Simmons just turned 25. That is a very young core that you can build around for the future. And these 3 first-round picks don't mean anything if you make the playoffs these 3 years. But it's tough. It's very, very tough. Listen, I'm a fan of a team that literally just did this. We traded 3 first-round picks in the last 6 months to get a team that should make the playoffs, but probably won't win a championship. But you can convince your fans that making the playoffs is good enough right now. It is. And maybe it's not the same because Chicago's a big market and the Bulls are trying to get to the point where they're free agent buyers once again, or I guess for the first time, and Sacramento probably won't be free agent buyers ever, like getting a big name free agent. So it's maybe a little bit different. A smaller market team might want to hold on to these picks because this is the way you elevate your team, as in a team like a Lakers or a Knicks or things like that could potentially sign a big name. I don't really know. So you let me know what you think. Sacramento Kings, what are their chances of making the playoffs this season? Is it too late for them to make some significant moves? I don't know. Sacramento Kings fans, I'm really interested in what you think. Man, let me know what you think about this lighting, bro. It took me like 30 minutes to try to get this lighting to look and feel different. Thank you.